is a verification of the diffraction phenomena. The diffraction is when a ray of light travels from a sharp edges or the round corners, the ray of light bends. The bending is known as deviation. Now this is an incident ray is there, this is a sharp edge is there, the deviates, and deviation known as the d. Now d is the angle of deviation. Now this can be achieved by is known as the diffraction grating. Diffraction grating consists of 15,000 lines per square inch now, and this is known as a diffraction grating. Now diffraction grating has got a constant, that is called a grating constant. Now this 15,000 lines per square inch is converted to the number of lines per centimeter. This becomes 5,906 lines per centimeter. Then when you take 1 upon m now, that becomes 1.69 into 10 raised to minus 4 centimeter. Now this is known as a diffraction grating. Now to find the wavelength, we are using the formula that is called a Bragg's law here. For Bragg's law formula is n lambda is equal to d sin theta. This theta is the angle of deviation, d is the constant here, the lambda is the wavelength, and n is the order, first order and second order, like this. Now for the red light, we can find the value, the standard value for the wavelength of the red light, the laser light is 6823 angstrom it is. Now this is, when you do the actual experiment, you can find that this is a laser source, we are calling it the laser source is there. This is a diffraction grating is there. The line is supposed to be in the straight line like this, n is equal to 0, but this line takes a diffraction, the deviation is there with an angle theta. This is called as n1. Now n1 is a first order, and similarly n2 is the second order. Now it become other side also, n1 is first order and n2 is the second order. Now this becomes the capital D. The capital D is the distance between your diffraction grating and also the screen. Now capital D is the distance between diffraction grating and the screen. Now actually we are varying this. When you change this, what happens? This and theta changes here. When theta changes, then what happens? Now the distance between this, that means center to the n1 and center to n2 also changes. Now this also varies by varying this value, the d value. Now whenever the actual experiment is there, this is known as a laser source. Now this is a bench is there, and which we can make the, this can move here. This is a laser source, this is giving the red light, laser light is coming from this one. Now this is a diffraction grating is there, as I told you there are 15,000 lines per square inch are there. The light is coming from this and entering into the diffraction grating, they getting diffracted here. You can find this is a, the first one, this is a parent is there, n is equal to 0, this is n is equal to 1, this is also n is equal to 1. Now actually what we are doing here, this distance we are changing. So we are various distances, for example, now you can observe here, this is varying here, you can see the distance is increasing here, as when you come very close to each other, you can find that it is decreased. Now that means you can say this is the first order, this is second order here, and on this side also there is a first order and the second order is there. Now these distances can be measured by using the scale. Now you can use a scale and you can measure these distances like this, from the center to the first order here, roughly I tell you, from center to the first order and from center to the second order. Now these are taken as a distances, and they are for the n1 and n2, first order and second order. Now this is how actually you wanted to perform the experiment. Now you can see the tabulation part here, tabulation part. Now this is serial number, I have taken 3 readings here. The distance between grating and screen, capital D, with the 3 varies, 3, 7.5, 8 and 8.5. Now these are the 3 different values of the capital D is there. Order of diffraction is there, first order and second order. Now this is calculated by x1 is equal to xa plus xb upon 2, similarly for x2, xc plus 60 upon 2 rom. Now these values are in centimeter we have taken. Now this becomes 3.55 centimeter, this is 11.4 centimeter is there. The similarly you can observe here, the distance increase now, 3.5, 10.8. now you can see the distance also increased now, 3.6, 11.7. now the further calculations are done, the tan theta is equal to x upon d for first order and second order. Now using this one, we will get the fractional values, 0.47 for first reading, 0.46 for second reading, 0.42 for second reading. For second order, you can find the 1.52, 1.35, 1.37. Now then the angle of diffraction theta can be calculated. The theta is here 25.1, 24.7 and 22.7 year. This is for second order, 56.6, 53.4 and 53.4. Now we are taking the values. Then here you are coming to this, calculate the lambda 1 and lambda 2. The lambda 1 and lambda 2 calculated by this formula. Then you can see that the mean lambda can be calculated from this one. Now finally, the lambda 1, 2, 3, the mean can be taken here. You are calculating this one, the formula by using, that is a your ln lambda sine theta. You are calculate this one now. So this is 68.80 angstrom minute. We got the value for this one. Now this is a graph is there. You can see how they have plotted the graph here. Now these are the center is there. For example, center. This is first order. This is second order now. This is first order distance is taken like this. Second order this much now. Similarly for second order, this is distance. And other side also distance are there. Now these distance can measure 10.9, 10.9. And first order 3.5 and 3.5 now. Likewise, this experiment can be repeated for the 3 readings. And you will find that you will get the result. Wavelength value is 68.80 angstrom now. Actually, it is this value is for red light. This becomes as 68.23 angstrom now. This is a standard result is that the lambda for the red light is, this is 68.23 angstrom now. Now this is how we wanted to do this experiment, and we wanted to find the value for the lambda, which obtained is 68.80 angstrom.